scary. Here's some good 16-bit graphics. Even that vulture looks fucking depressed. What the hell is this? A ghost giving a castle a blowjob? The game starts up with no storyline, no explanation, no nothing. You're just some guy standing in a castle who looks like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, or perhaps Peter Pan with a mullet. You have multiple doors to choose from. Two of them have question marks, but it doesn't make any sense because every room is just as much a question as the others. This one says BK on it. What the fuck does BK stand for? Burger King? I hope. If I go in there and I'm getting served hamburgers, that would be the tits. Once inside, it becomes a platform game, and it looks like shit. Come on, fucking bats. How cliche. Man, that dragon sure looks scary. I'm gonna have nightmares over that. Could they have made the dragon look any more cute? Oh, that's neat. Graffiti on the walls, gamers rule, and ooh, what?
Saddam was here? As in Saddam Hussein? What was he doing going around writing on castle walls? And gamers rule? That's the same handwriting. So Saddam was a really hardcore gamer?
The music. It's just one loop. One single piece of music that plays over the whole fucking game. It's the most cliche horror music they could have found. You recognize it. It's that famous Bach composition, you know, the one that everybody thinks is from Dracula. Once you've heard it for a half hour straight, you get sick of it. Fortunately, you have the option to turn the music off, but you have to turn it off at the right time, when there isn't a note playing, or else it sustains it. Isn't that the fuckest thing you ever heard? Did anyone test this shitty thing out? Also, whenever you die, the music comes back on again, so you have to keep turning it off. The giant fatal flaw with this game is the control. It looks like I'm playing like shit, but I'm actually trying my best. The controls are fucked up beyond belief, and that's the hardest thing to explain. There is no way I can do it justice. The only way to know is to play it yourself, and I fucking dare you. The first problem is that you're nearly defenseless. The only weapon I found is rocks that you throw. Couldn't this guy get a sword or something? And the way you throw them defies all common sense when it comes to gaming. You don't just hold the D-pad in the direction you want to throw. Instead, you have to gradually turn your arm around in a clockwise or counterclockwise motion until it's pointing in the right direction. Try doing this when there's a million enemies and projectiles trying to kill you. There's not enough time to turn your arm around before you're dead. Why couldn't this just operate like any normal game? Whoever came up with this idea is nuttier than squirrel poop. Even the stairs are a complete pain in the ass. It's hard getting on the stairs, it's hard getting off the stairs. The game simply doesn't do what you tell it to do. You rock the D-pad all over the place until you get lucky. Trying to grab the ropes, that's another thing. I don't even understand how it works. Sometimes you get lucky, and other times you don't. The strange thing is that it's not like the character is missing the ropes. He just stops in midair and falls straight down. Trying to pick stuff up, down and B. Would it be too much trouble to ask to just be able to walk over the item? To be able to touch it without having to stop and risk getting killed? As you notice, you can duck. It's done by pressing down and B. But it only ducks for like a second. To stay ducking, you have to press up and B. Yep, pressing up to duck is pretty fucked up. But other than that, I just can't describe how this control feels. It is so awkward and stiff that I honestly thought something was wrong with my controller. That is totally inexcusable to make a game where the challenge is not in the game itself, but in handicapping the player. You have better luck playing Silver Surfer with the power glove. Some of the games that have the worst controls are Karate Champ on NES, and a lot of ones I've reviewed already, like Spider-Man on Game Boy, Kid Cool on NES, the Zelda CDI games, Terminator 2 on SNES, any of the Action 52 games, Lesser the Unlikely on SNES, and I believe I said Winter Games on NES was the absolute worst when it comes to control. But now that I've played Dark Castle, this might take the cake. It's hard to compare because they're two totally different kinds of games. I'd say, at least for a platforming game, this is the worst I've played yet. And out of all the shit I've played, that's saying a lot. This game has sucked its fair share of ass, but now it's going for some more. Your character is a total buffoon. Everywhere you try to walk, he trips over things. You think his fucking shoelaces are tied together. And he keeps getting dizzy. I don't know why it happens, but it happens constantly. He steps on something or touches something or whatever, and he starts spinning around, which leaves you vulnerable to attacks. This dizzy bullshit should be reserved for fighting games like Street Fighter. Even there, I think it's annoying. It just gives the other person a free shot. But at least it makes sense because you're getting hit in the head. This guy, it doesn't even matter. He gets touched on the foot and he gets dizzy. He also has no ability whatsoever to drop down from any height. He can be 2 fucking feet from the ground and it kills him, or at least sends him into a spinning frenzy. There's random pitfalls everywhere. Trap doors open up, anvils fall on you. It's a nightmare. To make things even harder, most of the enemies never seem to die. Hit them with a rock, they fall down for about 5 seconds and get right back up. Meanwhile, you're still trying to windmill your arm around to kill the other guys, so you're never gonna be able to kill everything on the screen. It's hard enough just trying to navigate this guy without stumbling all over the place. They make it as difficult as it can possibly be. And if that's not enough, they have to fuck you in the ear with obnoxious sound effects. It's as if the game is literally making fun of you. On top of everything, it's one of those maze-like mindfuck games where you never know where to go. Can I go here? Nope. Can I go there? Nope. What about here? Nope. 3 spots on the same screen, all dead ends. Well, if it's a dead end, why can't they make it look like a dead end? Put a wall there or something! Why does it have to look like a wide-open passageway? Anywhere you fall down drops you into this torture room where people are getting whipped. I'm not even kidding by saying I've been playing this game for about a half hour, and I've somehow ended up in the same room probably 100 times. It's like playing a Monopoly game where every space on the board says go to jail, and there's no way out. I happen to find a key, but I can't figure out what it does. I tried every spot I can think of, but this key is as useless as boobs on a bull. Anything you do, you're fucked. Try this, you're fucked. Try that, you're fucked. You're fucked, you're fucked, you're fucked, you're fucked, you're fucked, you're fucked, you're fucked. And more cartoonish, and the controls, oh my fucking god, it's even worse. I can barely even fucking move. The control is impossible. You can't control it. You have more control over the weather than you do in the character in the game. I keep dying instantly on the first screen. I can't even move an inch before I get bombarded with a Space Invaders ensemble of bats. Jeez, you can't even let me walk 2 feet before raining enemies down on me? It still takes just as long to aim your arm at somebody. And you can get dizzy just by jumping.